I've been watching so many Skyrim videos people have posted in the last, I don't know, maybe 6 months. Just to see what people think of the game, you know, after 7 years. It's almost the 7th year anniversary. Some people remember where they were on, what was it? Do your death move.
You have failed.
Yeah, on 11/11/11, some people remember where they were on that day.
A life without faith is a life without beacon.
So we're gonna go get another winch. She's holed up in some cave mine thing. I thought I'd be different and go this way to get there, and I got confused. You know how you want to go somewhere and then you end up. You see a flag waving somewhere, and you're like, what's that? I want to see. I had to stop for a bit, wait for a car that was playing ghetto music to hurry up and go through the red light. So now I'm back. I'm not a fan of high decibel crap coming out of people's car windows. No one ever blasts. You notice no one ever blasts classical music from their car. You never hear it. No Beethoven, no Mozart. I totally missed. Lord, my sword went right through.
I wish you would go to Cyrodiil with me someday.
I don't know. Can I surrender? I guess I can surrender
we
to a
bring
troll.
The light to this place. What do you need to take?
So I just used a cheat code to kill the troll. I didn't feel like fighting the thing naked. I just want to get through this. But I think I forgot to get the stuff. I think I left. The troll took my money, and I don't think I got the money back from the troll. So I'm like, I'm destitute.
So be it.
That was like 6,000 gold that the troll took from me. Anyway, if I just go outside and run around and kill stuff, I usually come back with like 4,000 gold worth of stuff. The trick is finding somebody who has that much money to buy from me. The better you get at bartering, the harder it is to get. To find people with enough money to buy your stuff. Because you're asking for way more than what it's worth to them. But you have such great barter skill, they'll pay any price for your junk. Come on, where are you? Okay, there you are. Are we there yet?
We must purge the evil that lurks here.
Oh, I wanted to give you one more weapon.
What do you need to do?
I guess the fight begins.
Is the talking done?
I'm all hitting the wrong key in the dark.
For the Empire! What is your plan?
Playing Skyrim in the dark with a black keyboard.
What do you need to take?
My next life, I'll own a keyboard that lights up in the dark, I think.
Goodbye.
Great voice acting. Goodbye. Maybe I'm just used to how Velia says it. Goodbye. Or how that bard says it. Wilbert. Goodbye. Anyway. Why am I running all weird? I must have still got smacked around by that troll. I don't remember holding my broadsword like this when I was running. I hit the swing button and nothing swings. Maybe they're getting critical hits, and when that happens, I just don't get to swing my weapon. That's kind of cheesy, if you ask me.
No mercy for the wicked. Unlike the...
Why was that guy so tough?
Noble girls.
How bulletproof is his fur armor?
We were never pressured into marrying someone. My parents respect our thoughts.
Oh, is that someone chasing me? I thought there was a dead person up here, but I guess they're still alive and they're chasing me. Oh, we can do this all day. Where's Livia?
For High Rock, for the Empire.
Okay, where'd the guy go? Oh, yeah, that's the wrong way. Where is he? I'm just goofing around, and all I'm doing is making the game worse. Maybe I should just kill NPCs when they spawn, instead of running back and forth on maps. Okay, it's gotta be here. I remember him kicking my ass from around. He blindsides me. Or maybe I just... Oh, there he is. Maybe I had enough...
You have no honor.
Oh, there we go. Oh, come on! What kind of move is that?
For Cyrodiil.
Why can't I hit the guy?
Fall beneath me.
Okay, now I'm hitting him.
You might have escaped the law, but you cannot escape justice.
Die! Die!
You're done plaguing this place.
Maybe I've got like a disease, so all the weapons I have skill with turn to suck. It seems like my blade just wants to go through people and not connect with anything. And then I waste perfectly good stamina swinging a sword through somebody, and it doesn't even hit them. God, it just reminds me of Dungeons & Dragons and how much those rules suck. To this day, even, they suck. Fifth edition sucks. Stupid two-hit roll. I hate old-school revival games. Or old-school renaissance, whatever you want to call it. OSR games suck. their crappy two-hit rolls. And the AC and the DC nonsense and the save rolls. Save rolls are the dumbest thing ever. And unfortunately, Skyrim borrows a lot of crap from Dungeons & Dragons. You know, if you're playing Dungeons & Dragons with a percentile dice instead of a d20, that's Skyrim. What can you do? You know, some people swear by the d100 rules that RuneQuest used. Some people swear at the rules.
Is someone there?
You know, D100 rules are fine if you're doing a simulation kind of thing. But it's kind of crappy because you have this percentage, you know, you have a... It doesn't matter how good you are, you just have this percentage of... How good you're gonna do something.
The whites take you.
Like, you know, you'll have a good... What is it called?
For Cyrodiil.
You picked a bad time to get lost, friend.
You're goodly skilled at swinging a sword.
The bandits are without honor nor mercy.
It doesn't matter how good you are.
Of all villains.
There's always going to be that 1% chance that you're going to critically fail.
You might have escaped the law, but you cannot escape.
It doesn't matter how bad you are at swinging a sword. You're going to have that 1% chance of critical success. Even though you're super crappy at swinging a sword, there's always that 1% chance you're gonna decapitate something. One hit and I'm down. Lucky hit. So my game's set to auto surrender to bandits. Only to bandits though. I think anything else I just bleed out, I guess. So we're tied up. She stole our stuff. Let's see, the plan is to break free. I think breaking free is based on your lockpick skill. Yeah. I do some fancy maneuver where I lift my legs up and pull my arms out from under my legs, and now my arms are in front of me instead of behind me. And then we run outside, look for somebody to untie me. We're fugitives. Okay, so now we're back. Let's see what happened.
What can I do for you?
So I came back, killed the rest of the bad guys. Rescued the wench that was in there, and now we're off to, I guess we're going back to Windhelm. Return this one to the, I'll bring this one over to the Candlehearth Hall, I think that's what I did. Apparently there's a new version of Immersive Wenches, 161, I went to the Nexus and I didn't see it, so it must have been taken down the minute it was uploaded. Because just 160 is still on the Nexus. Maybe Patreon users, maybe they're getting 161 in advance of the general population, which would be me.
I'm on a pilgrimage, trying to preserve the goddess of twilight.
But 160 seems to be working okay for me. It's got some weird glitches.
Bandits harass the caravans at every step. But Khajiit... A few days ago we were ambushed. A nuisance, really. But many of the marauders had quick fingers. One of them stole my moon amulet. Given to me by my mother when I was just a cow. It is my only memory of home.
I must have gone back in time because I thought I had done this quest already.
You are kind to offer.
My moon amulet.
The bandits are part of a group headquartered here.
That is one of the best voice actors ever.
I missed my amulet. But a life cannot be replaced as easily. May your road lead you to warm sands.
There's, quote-unquote, cat people in the Traveler game that I play. I was thinking, if they ever make a movie of Traveler, I wonder what the cat people will sound like. In my role-playing games, you can't tell what they're saying. You have to have a voice translator. Because they're frickin' lions? They can't make the sounds that humans can. But who knows, in the movies, they might have him talk like Liam Neeson or something. Or who's the guy in Wizard of Oz? The guy, he breaks out in singing just like Livia does. If I were king of the forest! That guy. Anyway. Let me at him! Let me at him! Sometimes his outfit worked in the movie, and sometimes you could tell right away that it was a clown suit he was wearing. If you look carefully, you won't see the wire wagging his tail
horses,
around.
All day long. Do you have any idea how dull horses are? Farewell.
I can't believe Wizard of Oz was filmed in 3 weeks. That's mad. That's crazy mad. That's 18-hour days you're putting in. You know, child labor laws being violated, that kind of thing. People working with missing teeth and fingers. Running around half naked on the set. It's during the Depression, you know.
Fresh fruit and vegetables for sale.
And they were filming in color?
No.
Imagine if Wizard of Oz was filmed in Cinerama. They would have three... you know, practically like three cameras. That'd be insane.
This is more delicate.
I mean, who does that?
I did that engraved piece just last month.
This is the Royal Armor Line.
Then you have to build build theaters with three projectors. Using a 72 by 25 aspect screen.
Everyone says Yorland Greymane is the best smith in Skyrim. I plan to change a few minds about it. Of course. Don't let my words cut you. Jarl wants getting the ring. If you find that sword, traveler, I'll be grateful. Take a look.
Looks like I just fast-forwarded through a conversation of him talking about a sword. I remember when I returned his sword, I went into his house for the very first time in my Skyrim life. I don't know about you, but his house is always locked. Always. It's never open. And for whatever reason, he happened to be in the house when I came back with the sword. So I got to go into his house, and he has the most amazing house I've ever seen in Skyrim. Or maybe I just haven't seen it before, so it's new to me, so it seems awesome to me compared to all the other houses I've seen in the game. I'll have to watch someone else's videos and see what they say about the inside of his house, but I think it's the bee's knees. For a blacksmith, he's got all that floor, you know, square footage in his house. So I wonder why, when modders make houses for Windhelm, you know, player houses in the Windhelm style, they don't make them like the blacksmith's house. They make these crappy, you know, carbon copies of what Viola lives in, or the Shatter Shield people live in, you know, just nonsense.
Hi, lady. Would you like to buy some flowers? Please. Not much, but I hope you like them.
And then this kid here.
Thanks for talking to me.
I don't know what her issue is, but she's been missing a lot in my playthrough. She's never here selling flowers. I don't know where her hangout is anymore. I keep updating my mods, not really paying attention to the fine print as to what the updates change in the game. So I just assume that they're just bug fixes, but everything else still works the same, but no. Some updates are drastic changes to mods.
Get the cold out.
So NPCs end up going somewhere else. Anyway, so I was being stalked by a winch. I didn't know who it was, and then I realized, oh, it's the one I rescued. So that's what she looks like.
What can I do for you?
Because the whole time back here, she was covered from head to toe in fur.
What? Did you need something? All right, I'll take care of it.
Oh yeah, I don't know if she'll fix my ailment.
Oh, did you need something?
But it's worth a try anyway.
You've done well. Thanks a lot. Need something? Huh? I understand.
Good afternoon. Sure. What can I do for you? Yes. This one's a favorite of mine. A legend we all know and love. Our hero claims a war.
I'm gonna put a face light on her. I'm tired of not being able to see her face because it absorbs all the light in the room.
Alright then.
It doesn't seem to make much difference. I should have given her a brighter face light instead of the dark one. Oops. clicking on the wrong thing here.
Sure. What can I do for you? You must be a Stormcloak through and through to request that one.
Who's Clap? Anyway.
We drink to our youth, to the days come and gone, for the age of oppression is now nearly done.
Farewell. We'll drive. Hello, friend. Huh? See you.
She doesn't have many options.
Oh, did you need something?
Maybe in 24 hours when she gets reset or whatever, maybe she'll have the same options as the other wenches in here.
We're the children of Skyrim and we fight all our lives. And when Southern Guard beckons, every one of us dies.
Why is she so why is she so short?
But this land is
I'm guessing she's a Breton.
Of the scourge that has sullied our hopes and our dreams. Oh. Hail to Ulfric! You are the High King. In your great honor we drink and we sing.
That's it? She just stopped singing?
Huh?
I admire the Nordic spirit of glory and
I understand.
In truth, I find it akin to my belief.
Every time I get ready to reset a room, Olivia starts talking or singing.
This here's Candlehearth Hall. Great rooms upstairs, and there's a bed for rent on the ground floor. Of course. I understand. Excellent. I think you'll be glad you made this decision. Thank you. I'll be sure to put it to good use.
I don't remember doing that. I wonder if I kept this safe. Waiting for NPCs to start chit-chatting with each other and talking to the wenches, but it's not happening. So I'm gonna see if I can get this merchant to move towards me.
Yes.
So the innkeeper can go behind the table because she's stuck. She won't
Take
do
a
her.
Look.
She won't finish her script until she gets back to her workstation.
Until next time.
And don't break nothing.
Tidings.
Man, he really wants to lean against that post there.
How are we doing over here?
If it's a mercenary you're looking for, you found him. There's no stronger sword arm for hire in all Skyrim.
That was it then. The barmaid here, she was, or the innkeeper, she was clogging up the scripts.
About Talos?
So now
he
they're talking.
The Empire.
So now there's music playing, there's talking
Blessings
going
of Talos
on.
Be upon you. What is the purpose of freedom if it is without honor?
Okay, play a song or something. Do something. Nope. Oop, I'm walking on someone's head. What's going on here? God, that face light I gave her is barely noticeable. Man, now you can't even tell if there's a head there staring at you. Except for the eyeballs, maybe. Okay, I did give her a brighter face light. Good. Good.
Yes? Farewell.
There's one other dark elf in my game that has that same color skin. I can't remember where she lives. Oh, maybe yes? It's the girl who collects Nurn roots or something.
Good day.
Her skin is really, 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 really absorbent of light. And her sister, too. They both seem to absorb light.